Today's topic is logistics and supply chain management. Subject code U18 PLPL 514. I am Satish J, Assistant Professor, Bharat Institute of Law, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai. Introduction of transportation. The transportation refers to the movement of production from one location to another, as it makes its way from the beginning of supply chain to the customer. Transportation is an important supply chain driver because the products are rarely produced and consumed in the same location. The transportation is an important supply chain driver because the produced and consumed in the same location. The role of transportation in the supply chain management, that is key drivers. First one, shipper. The party who wants to transport and produce from one place to another place, that is called shipper. Next one, carrier. Carrier is a company that moves the goods from one place to another place. Same thing, shipper and carrier. The party who wants to transport the product from one place to another is called shipper. The carrier is a company that moves one goods to one place to another, that is carrier. For example, DHL, FedEx, etc. Transportations. Truck transportations. Trucking industry is divided into two parts, that is TL or LTL. TL means truck load and LTL means less than truck load. That is TL means the TL is the price display the economic of scale with respect to the distance of travel. The TL shipping suited for transportation between the manufacturing facilities and warehouse. That is called transportation TL. LTL means the LTL operations are priced to encourage the shipment in small lots. Usually the less than half of TL is LTL shipping is situated for shipment that are large to be mailed as small packages. That is LTL. The small packages packing in the LTL. Next one, road transportation advantages. It is a relatively cheaper mode of transportation as compared to another modes. It is a flexible mode of transportation as loading and unloading the goods from the destination. It provides a door-to-door service also. It helps to carry goods from one place to another. In places which are not connected by other means of transport, like hilly areas, also. Limitation of road transportation. Due to the limited carrying capacity, the road transportation is not economical for the long distance transportation of goods. That is the main thing. Transportation of heavy goods or goods in bulk by road involves high cost. Next one, air transportation. Air fractionation is commonly used by the companies who work with short lead times or advanced service leads. That is the air transportation. Air transportation is the best suited for small or high value items or time sensitive emergency shipment to be delivered to a particular distance with a short time. That is, have to travel a long distance. Air carriers normally move shipment that have high value but light weight. Advantages of air transportation. It is the fastest mode of transportation. It is very useful in transporting goods to one area to another, which are not accessibly by any other means. Reduce lead time. It helps to reduce the lead time. Improve service levels. Disadvantages of air transportation. It is a relatively more expensive mode of transportation. It is not suitable for transporting heavy or bulky goods. It is not suitable for short distance travel. Package carrier. Package carriers are transportation companies which carry small packages. For example, FedEx, UPS, DHL are other example for the packing carriers. The package carriers use air transportations, truck transportations, railway transportations to transport the goods. The package carriers also provide other values, other value added service that are allow shipper to inventory flow or track order status. Shipper can proactively inform the customer about their packages. The package carrier is suited for e-business also. Next one, rail transportation. Rail transportation uses fresh trains for the delivery of the batch piece. Fresh trains are usually powered by diesel, electricity and steam engines. The rail is suited for a bulk shipment of products like fertilizers, cements, food trains and coals, etc. These are the production plant to warehouse. That is, transportation helps to production plant to warehouses. Advantages of rail transportation. It is a relatively faster than road transportation. It is suitable for carrying heavy goods in large quantities over long distance and cost effectively. Next one, limitations of rail transportation. It is relatively expensive for carrying goods over short distance. It is not available in remote part of countries. It provides service according to fixed time schedules and it is not flexible for loading or unloading of goods at any place. Next one, water mode transportation. Water transportation uses the ships and large commercial vessels that carry billions of tons of cargo from one place to another. The water transport is used primarily for the movement of bulk or large commodities shipments and it is the cheapest mode of the carrying such load carriers. Water transport is particularly effective for significantly large quantities of goods that are non-perishable in nature and for countries or states that have water access. Next one, advantages of water transportation. It is a relatively economical mode of transportation for bulky or heavy goods. The cost of maintaining and constructing routes is very low. Most of them are naturally made this water transportation. It promotes international trade, but disadvantages. The depth and the river and canals vary and this affects the operation of different transportation businesses. It is a slow moving mode of transport and therefore not suitable for transport of perishable goods. It is adversely affected by weather conditions. Sea transport requires large investments of ships and their maintenance. Next, pipeline mode of transportation. Pipeline is used primarily for the transport of crude petroleum, refined petroleum products and natural gases. It includes a significant initial fixed cost in setting up the pipeline and related infrastructures. pipelines are not flexible and this scope is limited with respect to commodities. Respect to the commodities, it unable to transport a variety of materials. Intermodal transportation. Intermodal transportation is used for more than one mode of transportation for the movement of shipment from origin to its destination. International mode operation is used to two or more mode of transport to take a advantage of inherent economic of each and this provide the integrated service at lowest cost. For example, truck, water, railway. Next one, what is supply chain? The products and service from the supply chain is main thing was raw material manufacture. Next one, intermediate products manufacture. Next one, end product manufacture. Next, wholesalers and distributors and retailers. Next, connected by the transportation and the storage of activities involved in the supply chain. Integrated through information, planning and integration activities of supply chain. The cost and service levels of supply chain to be maintained. What is supply chain management? Supply chain management is a set of approaches utilized to efficiently integrate suppliers, manufacturers, warehouses, and stores so that the merchandise is produced and distributed at the right quantities to the right location and at the right time in order to minimize the system wide cost while satisfying service levels requirement. The principles of supply chain management. Adopt supply chain to customers' need. First one, adopt supply chain to customers' needs. Both the business people and the supply chain professionals are trying to focus on the customer's need. In order to understand the customer better, then we divide the customer into a different group of and we call it the segmentation. We divided the customers into different groups. That is called segmentation. The most prominent way to segment of customer is ABC analysis. The groups of customer based on the sales or value or profitability. The segmentation can also be done by products, industry, trade channel. Back then, Anderson suggests that the customer segment based on the service needs, namely sales and budgeting needs and the order fulfillment needs. This is adoption supply chain to the customer needs. Next, the customized logistics network. When you segment of a customer based on service needs, you may have to tailor the different logistic network to service different segment. However, this principle does not hold true for all situations. For example, if you were the contract manufacturer in China, for example, you might already have different logistics network for different customers. Each customer in US or you, India, for example, might already control the source of raw materials. As you were to provide the dedicated production lines, nominate 3PL companies and air or sea carriers. So the logistics network design is a kind of initiative driven mainly by the customer. This is called the customized logistics network. Next one, align the demand planning across supply chain. The supply chain participant practitioners are the key to share the demand data with trading partners so nobody has to keep the unnecessary stock. In general, this principle holds true. But in the reality, only the Walmart is the actually sharing the demand that data to trading partners. The only Walmart is actively sharing a demand data to trading partners. If you make the demand forecast based on SKU, store level using the POS data you get from the retailers is more accurate than using your own historical order data. The implementation is that the absence of demand to share the necessary band. When you got the demand of data for trading partners, you must use in the right way of demand planning to the across of supply chain management. Next one, differentiate the products closer to the customer. For example, Dell keeps the components and assembles them only after the customer places the order. In order to increase the product varieties, this principle is still true, but there is another principle that you should consider. Next one, differentiate the product closer of demand. Standardized is the opposite of polarized of differentiation. For the cosmetic manufacturers, formulate the products and choose their packing and labeling that complies with the regulation of multiple countries in packing and labeling them all over globe or Asia. So they only make one SKU that can be sold in 15 countries instead of one country. By the standardized product appropriately, they can drive the cost down due to the economic of the scale. So standardized is something that you should also consider. Next one, outsource strategically. This is the principle that stands to test of time. In short, don't ever outsource your core competency from one company to another. More information about the outsource can be found from the information graphics name of the particular company. Next one, develop IT that supports the multi-level decision making. If you search Google, for example, the critical success of factor for ERP, you will find lot of information about how to implement the ERP successfully. My opinion is that an IT project shouldn't be done in the isolation. Business process reengineering is something that you have to do before implementing an IT project. This is well equipped you with full understanding about the process and define that the determine what kind of technology that are going to use for the process. That is the decision making for the development of IT. Adopt both service and financial markets. Anderson suggests that the activity based costing implemented so you can determine the customer's profitability. However, that is the interest twice about the ABC concept. That is for ABC analysis. The advantages of supply chain management for small companies. To remain competitive, small firms have to offer superior quality goods at the lowest price possible. The need to minimize product cost makes effective supply chain management better. There are costs involved in every process of product life cycle, and it is the responsibility of management to ensure that their costs are kept low So the company can continue to the pass along this third saving to the consumer. Next, reduce cost. How to reduce the cost of the company? Supply chain management involves identifying those processes that increase costs without increasing the value of the final project or final product. These processes are wasteful and do not add value and should be eliminated whenever it's possible. Next, increased efficiency. Resource wastage is a common source of increased production of. This is due to improved planning. The improved planning of a company that employs supply chain management is able to achieve the efficiency of operations, since only those value-adding activities are encouraged. This ensures that the organization process flows smoothly and output keeps in line with the company's need. Next, increase output. A company that employs supply chain management can foster close-knit relationship with its suppliers and customers, both the suppliers and the customers, ensuring the timely fulfillment of orders. A company known for its timeless and responsiveness will attract more customers and will grow as a result of increased output of the sales and production. Increase profit. How to increase the profit? Businesses exist to make profit. One of the most efficient way of increasing a company's profit is by ensuring that the costs are kept as low as possible. The application of supply chain management by a small company lead to cost reduction due to elimination of wasteful processes. Since this are operating cost for the company, the saving of this cost reflect increased profits by a company. The four elements of supply chain management. Next one, supply chain management integrates the management of supply and demand. According to the Council of Supply Chain Management Professionals, it encompasses the planning and management of all activities involved in sourcing and procurement, conversion and logistics. The supply chain management also covers the coordination, collaboration with the channel partners, such as the customer, supplier, distributor, and service providers. Next, demand management. From the demand management, what is the demand management? The demand management is an essential element in supply chain management to focusing the companies and their partners on meeting the needs of customers. Rather than the production process, the lead company in the supply chain makes the partners aware of customers' needs, in encouraging them to maximize the components or supply chain quality and add value to the finished product by raising awareness of customers' needs and increasing the collaboration of company can improve the competitiveness of the whole supply chain and increase the business opportunity for all members. That is demand management. Next, communication. Effective communication helps the entire supply chain improve the efficiency and productivity of its operation. By enabling all members to share the same demand on operational information, communication keeps all members informed of developments that affect their contribution to the supply chain, enabling them to quickly adjust their operations in line with changing the demand conditions. Effective communication also enables the members to respond rapidly to new business opportunities. For helping the new products to market quickly or increasing the supply chain levels to follow the successful market of the company. Integration. What is integration? Integrating the supply chain process to help each member to reduce its inventory cost, a key to successful supply chain management. According to a case study on the retailer, for example, at Walmart by the University of San Francisco, the suppliers share up to the data information and demand to route their products to Walmart warehouses for onboard shipment to the stores within minimum time in inventory. This reduced the Walmart's cost sufficiently, enabling them to offer customers highly competitive pricing to achieve his level of integration. Companies development single information network that enable all members to assess the supply and the demand data of security, or securely the process to be the network of the process on the standard level of internet protocol, so all the members can communicate each other from the different internal network. Next one, collaboration. Collaboration is the supply chain strength relationship between the members, improving the teamwork and helping all members in charge their business, lead companies, run business development and training programs to improve supply chain partners. Market and product knowledge. They also undertake joint new product development program with partners, contributing the specialists of knowledge of components and materials. That is called the collaboration. The various stages of supply chain management. What are the various types of supply chain management? The supply chain, that is called CSCM, as it is popularly referred to, all of about the planning, management of activities involved in the sourcing and conversion. It also includes the coordination, collaboration with channel partners, which can be supplier, intermediators, third-party service providers, and the customers. There are different aspect stages in supply chain management. That is, some of the key aspects are mentioned below. First one, raw material, supplier, manufacturing, distribution, customer or consumer. From the raw material supply, first one, raw material supply. A supplier plays a critical link in the supply chain, forming the right partnership, the right term and the policies helps the development of a group's relationship with the supplier that will provide the benefit of all parties of to do involve the raw material supplier. Next one, manufacturer. After acquiring the right raw materials from the supplier, the organization has to make careful decision on the manufacturing on the product. The demand for the product, technologies required and other important decisions have to be carefully managed at this stage. That is manufacturer's process. Next one, distributors. The distributors could include the wholesalers and retailers. They are one of the important links between the organization and the customers. Next one, customers. They are the most important and also the end link in the chain. An organization should identify the customers, make sure that the product they produce what it requires. Besides, the above logistics is also an important factor in the supply chain management. The logistics is a plan, execute and control various aspects of supply chain from the point of origin to the point of consumption. For an organization to operate the smoothly and profitable, it is necessary for the supply chain to keep running. Decision phases in supply chain. Supply chain decision plan and operation are identified as three sufficient decision phases. The supply chain decisions, Supply chain strategy is another word used for this space. Supply chain design decisions or strategy decisions include the products to be manufactured in the location and the capacity of manufacturing plants and the warehouses, the mode of transportation to be utilized and information to be utilized. That is supply chain design. Next, supply chain plan. The supply chain planning typically done for a year. Established parameters within the supply chain will function over a specified period of time. That is supply chain plan. Supply chain operation. In this space, the time horizons all small monthly, weekly, and daily process of supply chain operations. The decision driven by customer order and are related to individual customer orders. There are also decisions related to individual production facilities, warehouses, and transportation. Next, process views of a supply chain. First one, cycle view. In the cycle view, the supply chain processes are divided into cycles that are performed at the interface between two successive stages of supply chain. And one describes the following cycles. That is customer order cycle, replenishment cycle, manufacturing cycle, procurement cycle. First one, customer order cycle. Normally occurs at the retailer place between the customer and the retailer. Activities involved in the customer arrival, the customer order entry, customer order fulfillment, customer order receiving, customer's fund payment. This is the customer order cycle. Replenishment cycle. Normally that will occur at the retailer or wholesaler or distributor interface. To acting involved retailer order trigger, retailer order entry, retailer order fulfillment, retailer order receiving, and fund payment from the replenishment cycle. Next one, manufacturing cycle. Normally thought to occur at the wholesaler, manufacturer interface during on the number of channels in the distribution channels. It can occur at the customer manufacturer or retailer manufacturer also. Activities involves order arrival, production scheduling, manufacturing and shipping, receiving by the person orders or fund payments. Next, procurement cycle, that is push or pull view, occurs at the manufacturer side or supply side. It is the view, pull process and push process are categorized and identified in a supply chain. Each supply chain will be have some pull, push process and the activities indicated by the customer. Orders from pull process activities. The activities indicate the carry out in anticipation of customer demand or push process activities. Importance of supply chain flow. Flow of information, materials and products and cash are important for supply chain function and fulfillment of objectives. Information is the key to produce as per customers order and also forecast the case of made to stock supply chain. Next, levels of activities in the supply chain. First one, strategic level, tactical level, operational level. Tactical level, long term decisions. Tactical level, medium term decisions. Operational level, day to day operations. In order to the make sure that the above, in order to the supply chain is running smoothly and also ensure the maximum customer satisfaction and the lowest possible cost. There are the three levels of activities from the management of supply chain management. First one, strategical planning. At this level, the senior management is involved in the supply chain process and making decisions that concern the organization. to collaborate the supplier, the type of products that should be manufactured for the core. Every effective supply chains of the strategic level to be ground work for the entire supply chain process. Choosing the site level of purpose of business facilities, creating a network of reliability, suppliers, transporters, logistics handlers, long-term improvement and innovation to meet time demand. Inventory and procurement management throughout its life cycle. IT program and segment to make the process more effective. Tactical management. The tactical level of activities focuses on achieving low cost of supply chain. The business should be short-term decision making. The tactical level should be big role in controlling the cost and the minimizing the risk. For the common concern, the procurement contract for necessary materials and services, production schedules and guidelines to meet quality, safety and quantity standards. Transportation and warehousing solutions, including outsourcing and third-party options. Inventory logistics, including the storage and end products distributions. Adopting the best practice in the comparison to the competitors. Operational levels. The operational level activities decisions are day by day basis, the shift along to the supply chain. The mistake of the companies, many companies make is to jump straight into the operational management without focusing the strategic and tactical levels. For the operational levels are daily and weekly focusing to the figure out of the satisfied demand. Production operations, including the scheduling and detailed management of goods in process, monitoring logistics activities for contract and order fulfillment, settling damages or losses with suppliers, vendors and clients, managing incoming and outgoing manufacturers and products as well as hand inventories. The technology and the supply chain management. In the technology of the maximized benefits of supply chain organization, to be need of investor technology to handle the enterprise's resource planning on the site. The web-based software and internet communications. The supply chain management is a branch of management that involves suppliers, manufacturers, logistic providers, and most importantly, the customers. The supply chain management process works through the implementation of strategic planning, customer with maximum satisfaction levels of lowest possible cost. This is the three levels of management process: strategic level, tactical level, and operational. Thank you.